members. I'm Shauna.
I'm Jordan.
And we're the owners and photographers behind Shauna and Jordan Photography.
Yeah, give it that.
And we're so excited to be with you here today for a golden nugget with Swell. And we're actually going to be talking a little bit about Instagram and how to use Instagram right now, some quick actionable steps to help clients find you on Instagram.
Yeah, tricky part. Clients finding you, not the other way around.
So one of the things that we always like to tell people is, first, in a quick explanation of how Instagram works, just in case you haven't really put a lot of thought into this, we all know how it works, but in terms of using it as a marketing aspect, Instagram is a social media platform that is not evergreen. So the reason I always love to mention this and preface with it is because essentially, after a certain amount of time has passed, your posts are no longer going to be as discoverable as they originally were. So for example, your blog posts, which rank for SEO, those are evergreen. They're going to continue to rank for SEO. Your posts on Instagram are going to slowly get lower and lower in people's feeds or in hashtag
searches.
Even
in your own feed.
And then, so essentially that means that in order to be discoverable on Instagram, you need to be posting content at least daily. And so I just want to go ahead and start with that. So with that said, we know that Instagram can either be your best friend or sometimes your worst enemy. So here's a few things that you can do right now to go ahead and just help with your discoverability and even with making your Instagram a little more attractive for people. So one,
I know the first thing is that you can easily change your, is it the name or your bio? Which part is it?
It is your name.
Okay.
So first of all, on Instagram, you have your handle, right? And your handle is for us, for example, it is at Shauna and Jordan Photography. Correct. But on Instagram, they also ask for you to put in your name. And your name, oftentimes we put our actual name there. So I could put Shauna Cooney in there. But what you'll find is you can actually use your name to make yourself discoverable on Instagram. So for example, if you're a destination wedding photographer, you might want to put destination wedding photographer as your name. Mm-hmm. If you are an event rental service, you might want to write Sarasota Event Rentals as your name.
Because if you think of Instagram, sorry to jump on you, if you think of Instagram kind of like Google, you have to put your brain in the perspective of a client. Like, what are they searching?
Mm-hmm.
If they're searching destination wedding photographer, you're going to be one of those people that pops up.
And that's exactly what I was going to say. So if a client is looking for Sarasota Event or, you know, Sarasota Event Rentals, and they type that into the Instagram search bar, your name is good. Your entire Instagram will pop up
business,
because that is your name on Instagram. The next thing that I always like to say is if you're running a personal brand, like a photographer or a DJ or etc., we highly recommend, unless you're running a major team, putting your profile picture as the photo on your Instagram. When people are looking at your Instagram, think of it as like, you know, your website's a handshake and your Instagram's a hug. And so when they come to that Instagram, they're wanting to get to know you a little bit better if you're running that personal brand. And so it helps them to make that connection, and it's one of our favorite little tricks. Third thing that I would say is definitely update your highlight stories. We are actually going to be in the process of updating like a little story that's like our services and kind of what makes us a little bit different from other photographers out there. Because you want to be calling your tribe. You want to be working with people who want to work with you. And by having, you want to stand out, right? And so there should definitely be that law of attract and repel. So that way use those highlights as a way to connect with your audience, let them get to know you. If they're a great client for you, then awesome. If they're not, then that'll kind of help to weed them out from you for you. So those are like my quick actionable things that you
even
can go ahead and do.
Even though the highlights might take a little bit of time.
But. Yeah, trust me, we've been holding off on doing them. But one of the other things that I always like to mention is to make sure that you are using hashtags on all of your posts. You can use up to 30 hashtags, and you wanna make sure that you're using a mix of large and small hashtags, meaning if you're using hashtag wedding, that's a very large hashtag.
Yes.
You're gonna get bumped down really quickly in that. But if you're using hashtag Tampa wedding planner, that's more specific.
Narrow the funnel down.
And you're narrowing the funnel down, which means that your photos are going to remain in that hashtag longer. Guys.
Because you can search hashtags.
Yeah. And Instagram is one of our number one referral sources for our clients, right there with word of mouth referrals. So all these things really do work because we use them on our own Instagram, and it's how we get discovered by clients.
Absolutely.
All the time.
All those things kind of add up to make you more discoverable by your client.
Yeah. And one of the other things that we always like to mention too is to make sure that you're engaging with your audience. If somebody takes the time to post a comment on your post, make sure you take the time to respond to them. And also, you know, take the time to respond to people in your your community. So, you know, other vendors who might be posting, taking the time to comment and like and support their posts goes a long way as well. So those are just a few really quick things. I could literally talk on this all day long. If you have any questions about Instagram or hashtags, you need, and if there's anything that we can help with, please feel free to like send me a DM on Instagram. I'm always on there. Mm-hmm. And we would love to help you guys in any additional way that we can. We hope that this can be a blessing to you in some way. And if you already know these things, you're like, Shauna, give me something else. Seriously, send me a DM. I love talking Instagram. So with that said, you guys, we hope that you have a wonderful day. We can't wait to hug you all at the next Smile event. And we just hope that you and your businesses are doing great. If there's anything that we can help you with, even outside of Instagram, please let us know. We're thinking of you all. Bye, guys.
Bye. I'm taking my freedom, putting it in my soul.